confirmed over 1,000 exoplanets, which are planets that orbit other stars. And those star systems have quite a few differences from this one. See, most solar systems have their larger planets orbit their host stars closer than Mercury orbits the Sun. In fact, in 1995, the exoplanet 51 Pegasi b was discovered, which has half the mass of Jupiter, but is 20 times closer to its star than Earth is to the Sun. These types of exoplanets, which are created with all the hot Jupiters, are quite common in other solar systems, yep. But weirdly, they are missing from ours. Coincidentally, hot Jupiter is also my college nickname. That's a story for another time. So why are our largest planets so far away from the Sun? Well, to be honest, scientists are those good old scientists, but that hasn't stopped them from coming up with hypotheses. And this is where the wandering Jupiter idea comes in. Some scientists believe that when our solar system was a little youngin', the Sun was potentially surrounded by super-Earth rocky planets. But then our good friend Jupiter moved inward, whose gravitational pull to orbits of these planets, causing them to collide with one another and, you know, smash them into pieces, some of which were hurtled into the Sun. What a way to go. However, as Jupiter later retreated, being pulled away from the Sun by the formation of Saturn, any leftover debris eventually formed into the rocky planets Venus, Earth, and Mars. And this does a good job of explaining why the inner planets are younger than the outer gas giants. So essentially, if this is actually what happened, if it weren't for Jupiter, life on Earth would not exist. Now, that's not saying that life wouldn't be possible at all, but Earth may not have ever formed if Jupiter hadn't come in and destroyed what was there before. And not only is Jupiter potentially responsible for allowing Earth to form, but it also helps protect you now. See, in the last decade alone, Jupiter has been hit by at least 5 comets or asteroids. In fact, recent images from March 17, 2016 show that Jupiter was hit by a small object, and these impacts are just the ones that we've seen. Some scientists predict that these collisions probably happen 1 to 5 times every month. And if it wasn't for Jupiter's huge gravitational force deflecting these objects away from Earth, you humans may have been struck by them instead. And honestly, as your friend, I don't recommend that at all. But there's also a theory that Jupiter might steer space rocks our way, possibly causing impact events. Man, Jupiter, I just don't know anymore. But we should still all be grateful that Jupiter exists. I mean, if it didn't, you probably wouldn't be here watching this video. And that'd be pretty sad, you know? On the topic of hypothetical questions, what if the Earth doubled in size? Check out this video. How would that change things? Well, first off, gravity would be very different. The Earth would have 8 times as much mass, and gravity would be twice as strong. There's a link in the description if you're on mobile. Make sure you come back every Monday for a brand new video. As always, I'm Blacko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking. Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. You Earthlings are pretty attached to your sun, and for good reason. It provides light and heat, and drives photosynthesis that makes oxygen, and helps generate weather patterns. With it, you wouldn't exist. But if the sun is so great, would it be better if there was more of it? What if the sun had twice the mass it has now? Too much of a good thing can be a bad thing, and in this hypothetical case, it would be so bad that no one would survive. But before I get to that, you probably know the sun is a star, and stars come in a variety of masses. Generally, a star with more mass, more matter packed into it, glows brighter and hotter than one with less. The smallest stars can be less than 8% the mass of the sun, and give off only 0.01%. Stars can be 100 times more massive than the sun, and emit thousands of times as much energy. Compared to these stars, the sun is actually a pretty normal mass. But that doesn't make its relationship to Earth any less special. Many planets are either too close or too far away from their stars to support life. Earth is in what we call the Goldilocks zone, or the habitable zone, where it is just far enough away from the sun to have the right temperature for life to exist. And we're not the only planet like this. Scientists believe there are billions of Earth-like planets in habitable zone. 2017, NASA announced they found 7 exoplanets 39 light-years away that might have water, and 3 of them are in their star's habitable zone. But all of them orbit their star closer than Mercury orbits the sun. So why don't they burn up? Well, distance is only part of the equation. These planets orbit an ultra-cool, very small dwarf star only 8% as massive as the sun. It's also half as cold as wasn't as bright. Being close to this star is the only way the planets could possibly capture enough light and heat to support life. If they were farther away, they would be too cold for life to exist. So back to your solar system.
If the sun were twice as massive as it is now, Earth would fall more mass, the sun's luminosity, the amount of energy and brightness it gives off, would increase exponentially. To see what might happen to you, let's look at Sirius A, the brightest star in your sky. It's just about twice as massive as the sun, but more than 20 times as luminous. It's also several thousand degrees hotter, well over 9,000 degrees Celsius, compared to 500 degrees for the sun. If the sun were that massive and Earth kept the same distance from it, you'd be toast. Maybe literally. Well, not literally. You wouldn't turn into bread. Never mind. Earth would not just get significantly hotter, but the oceans would boil away, leaving it even more heat. Plus, if the sun doubled in mass, its gravitational pull would increase. All of this would not be good for you, Earthlings. I think it's probably better to just appreciate the sun you have now. Let us know in the comment section below what you want us to talk about next. We're taking suggestions for future videos. And are you curious to know what would happen if the Earth doubled in size? Well, if you are, check out this video. Well, first off, gravity would be very different.
No.
The Earth would have 8 times as much mass, and gravity would be twice as strong. So if you stepped on a scale, you would suddenly...
Imagine neutron stars so fast they devour everything in their path. Clouds that smell of fruits, and enormous gathering of galaxies. And Louis Armstrong music in space? These are in our cosmos. The universe is enormous, fascinating, and full of secrets. With a history that is billions of years old, there are still millions of things to be discovered. Today, we'll tell you about 10 unbelievable things that are currently in space. But first, click the subscribe button and turn on notifications to be Brightsiders to watch our videos. Number 10. Black Widow. Mating is a dangerous business for a male Black Widow spider, since there's a big chance that the female will devour them while mating. That's why, in 1988, when scientists found a pulsar that seemed to devour a nearby star, they named it the Black Widow Pulsar. A pulsar of this kind is a neutron star that rotates at about 600 times per second and emits electromagnetic radiation. The Black Widow Pulsar orbits a brown dwarf star, and it completes the orbit in just over 9 hours. So it's basically a super fast spinning star. That sounds really cool.